Dear students, today we are going to learn about the first topic of first module for the course Biological and Chemical Instrumentation, and that is microscopy. In today's lecture, we will learn about the theory of microscopy. So, first of all, what is microscopy or how can we define microscopy? As the name indicated, microscopy, it means the study of object which are micro in size. So in microscopy we will learn about the instrument that is used to study the object which are micro in size. Micro in size means size which is less than 10 to power minus 6, and if we don't use any unit, then it means we are going to use the standard unit. So here we can say that micro size means the object which are less than or equal to 10 to power minus 6 meter in size. Now the question is, what are the microscope? So the microscope is an instrument or equipment that makes very small objects look big enough so that we will be able to see them through our naked eye. Now what are the prerequisites for this lecture? Before coming to this lecture, you people should know how to make the ray diagrams using lenses. You must aware with the refractive index, the definition of refractive index, and the impact of refractive index on the light rays. And you should also know about the wavelength of visible light. It means you know that if we are talking about red light or blue light, you must know that which color of light has longer wavelength and which color of light has shorter wavelength. Now the learning objectives of today's lecture is to understand the requirement of different type of microscope, to understand the magnification power of lenses or microscope, to understand the resolution power of microscope, to understand the difference between the magnification and resolution, because both the things are different from each other, and finally to understand the numerical aperture or angular aperture of the lenses used in microscopes. So students, with the help of this animation, I am going to explain you the use of microscope in biological sciences. We can use microscope to magnify the image of cellular or subcellular components. We can see the different cell division that happens within the cells. This is the image of division. We can see the movement of microbes, bacteria, viruses. And this is the animation to show how a microscope magnifies an image using an illuminator. This is the eye of the observer. There are so many types of microscope present in the lab. This is the image taken from bright field, dark field, phase contrast, confocal and fluorescence microscope. Now just have a brief how a microscope works. Each and every microscope has light source, light control knobs, diaphragm and a condenser that is mounted with a lens. This is the stage on which we have placed the object that has to be studied. We have a focus adjustment knobs, objective lenses, generally biconvex lens. We have an eyepiece or ocular in each and every microscope. This is a digital camera. This can be present in some of the microscope to take the picture of the object for further use. This is how we use our microscope. In this dish we have a microbe. You can see the image of the microbe has been magnified up to some extent. Now if we use the lens of more magnification, what will happen? The image will get more magnification like this. These are the light source from where the light is coming. You can see the path of the light, how the light reached up to the ocular and to the eye of the observer. These are the images taken from the microscope. These are the microbes. After more magnification, we can have a picture like this. You can see This is a picture of bacteria taken from a high magnification power of microscope. Now, with the help of this animation, I will explain how a single hand lens will magnify the image of this object and what will happen when we will use a compound microscope or the lens more than two. Okay, suppose this is your object. Now I am drawing a lens over here like this. Okay, this is the biconvex lens. Now one ray will pass through the focal length and one ray will pass through the optical axis, and you will get the image of your object at this place. Okay, just a minute, don't go to the drawing, this is just for the explanation. You will get the image of your object over here, which is magnified by n times using this biconvex lens, and this magnification is depend on the magnification ability of this single lens. Now suppose when we use compound microscope rather than using a single hand lens, what will happen? Okay, I am putting one more lens over here, right? Right. This is one more lens, and you are actually watching the image from this side. This is the eye of the observer, right? What will happen now? This image will play the role of object for this lens, and what will happen actually? One ray will pass through the focal length of this second lens, and one will pass through the optical axis of second lens, and you will get a much larger image formed by the second lens over here. Okay, just a minute, let me change the color of the object. This is how a compound microscope work to create a much larger or much magnified image of the object by using the product of magnification power of two lens. In case of compound microscope, this lens will be your ocular or the eyepiece, and this lens is the objective lens, because this lens is closer to the object and this lens is closer to the eye of the observer. I think now it is clear to you that how your compound microscope magnify the image many times as compared to the single hand lens. Okay, now we will learn about a new term, that is magnification. The magnification can be defined as the degree of enlargement of any image. Okay, so here we have written the magnification of the image of the object by compound microscope. Why we have used compound microscope to explain these terms? Because if you use a single hand lens to magnify an image, the single hand lens can also be considered as a microscope, but not as a compound microscope, because the compound microscope is a basic type of microscope in which we have used two or more than two lenses to magnify the image of the object. Okay, you all must have experience to work on the compound microscope. You can find an optical tube on which a lens is mounted from the top and from the bottom. The lens from the top will be near to the eye of the observer, and the lens at the bottom of the tube will be near to the object or the specimen that is under observation. So in compound microscope, we have used either two or more than two lenses to magnify the image. That's why this is known as the compound microscope. Okay. So in this lecture, if we learn about the different terms used for the microscope, we will generally use compound microscope as an example, because compound microscope is a primitive type of bright field or optical microscope that is generally found in the laboratory. So now coming to the magnification of the image by compound microscope. A bright field or compound microscope is primarily used to enlarge or magnify the image of the object that is being viewed, which cannot otherwise be seen by the naked eye. Magnification may be defined as the degree of enlargement of image of an object provided by the microscope. Magnification by a microscope is the product of the individual magnifying ability of the ocular and the objective. Now, what is ocular and what is objective? I already told you that in compound microscope, there are two lenses. The lens that is closer to the observer eye is the ocular, and the lens which is closer to the object or the specimen is known as the objective lens. And here, the magnification of the overall compound microscope is the product of the individual magnifying ability of the ocular and the objective lens. For example, if the ocular is 10x and objective is 40x, the specimen is magnified 400 times. Now, what is 10x and 40x? Suppose the object that is under study is of 1 micrometer in size, okay, and the ocular lens has capability to magnify the image of the object by 10 multiple. Means if the object is of 1 micrometer, the ocular will magnify it up to 10 micrometer, okay, and the objective has capability to magnify the object up to 40x. So the overall magnification of the compound microscope will be the product of 10x and 40x, and that will be equal to the 400x. Okay, so this should be very clear to you that the overall magnification of the compound microscope will be the product of the individual magnifying ability of the ocular and the objective. Okay, suppose for example, if an oil immersion objective of 100x is used along with the 10x ocular, then the specimen is magnified 1000 times. Means 100x into 10x is equal to 1000x. Okay. Now, coming to the factors that play an important role on the magnification power of the microscope. And these factors are the optical tube length, the focal length of the objective lens, and the magnifying ability of the ocular. Okay. Now, the total magnification of the object image can be calculated by the following equation. Total magnification is equal to the length of the optical tube divided by the focal length of the objective, multiply by the magnification power of the ocular. Theoretically, if the magnifying power of the ocular and objective of a compound microscope are increased, it should be possible to get higher and higher magnification. A magnification up to 3000 can be obtained by using high power lenses, but the image will be blurred and details will not be clear. This is due to the fact that in a microscope, not only the lenses but the wavelength of the light is also important, and this decides the resolving power of the microscope. Okay, now suppose you have taken a pic from your mobile and you enlarge that image slowly, what will happen? Up to some extent, your image will be pixelated or blurred. Okay, and this is actually decide the resolving power of the lenses that is used in your mobile. Similarly, here magnification power only magnify the image, but the magnifying power is not able to give better resolution of object after some limit. Okay, so in that case we have to use another term that will be able to explain why these images will get blurred or pixelate, and what is the impact of wavelength of light on the picture or the image of the object by and another term, that is resolving power of the microscope. Coming to the resolving power of compound microscope. The resolving power of a bright field or compound microscope can be defined as its ability to distinguish between two particles situated very close to each other. Okay, in a magnified image, the object should not only be larger, but the details should also be clear. Okay, suppose you are using your compound microscope to study a animal cell and you are enlarging your image by increasing the magnification power of your compound microscope, but up to some extent only you will get the clear picture. After that limit, if you magnify the image, you will not get the clear picture of the subcellular components like mitochondria, DNA, RNA, whatever. Okay, this was just an example. So there should be better resolving power of the compound microscope, so that if you increase the image, even after you will get a clear picture, your picture will not get pixelated or get blurred. Okay, this is possible when the microscope has the ability to see two points situated very close to each other as a two distinct entities. Suppose you have, just a minute, I am just giving you the example. Suppose these are the two. Now try to understand the difference between the magnification and resolution by using this picture. Here I have taken two pictures. This picture, which is on the left hand side of the screen, is only a magnified image of a smaller object, but here the picture, magnification of the picture is although same, but this picture is much more clear than this picture. It means we can say that in the picture of right hand side, we are getting better resolution of the object. This is actually the difference between the magnification and resolution. Magnification after a limit will pixelate or blur the picture, but when the microscope has better resolution, that will give a more clear picture of the object. Okay, one point, and this is the second point. Okay, now here I have used two different colors, that's why you are able to say that these are the two points. Suppose we are using the same color, now you people will not be able to say that either this is a single point or a double point. So in that case, if we used a microscope that has better resolution power, that microscope will be able to distinguish these two points which are very much close to each other, and the microscope will read these two points as a two different object. This is actually the resolution power or the resolving power of the microscope. Now the human eye has a resolving power about 0.25 millimeter in the sense two dots situated 0.25 millimeter or more apart can only be seen as two dots. If we will place two dots which are situated less than 0.25 millimeter to each other, then the human eye will not be able to distinguish these two points as a two different entities. The human eye will consider that as only one entity. Okay, so anything closer than this distance will appear like a single dot. This was actually the example, that's what I have given here by drawing the two objects. Okay, now I think this is clear to you that what is resolving power and what is magnification power. Now we will learn more about the resolving power, the factors that affect the resolving power of the microscope in the next slides. The factors that affect the resolution power or the resolving power of the microscope are the two. The first is the wavelength of the light, and the second is the numerical aperture of the objective lens. Now we will discuss both these parameters one by one. Now coming to the first parameter that affect the resolution power of the microscope, that is wavelength of light. If we are talking about the microscope, it means we are talking about the wavelength of visible electromagnetic radiation, and I assume that you all know what is wavelength. Okay, just telling you, wavelength is the distance between the two crest or two trough, or the distance that is used to complete one cycle by the electromagnetic radiation. Okay, so this is actually the length that is covered by the one cycle of electromagnetic radiation or the light waves. Okay, in light or bright field microscope, the wavelength of the light used for illumination falls on the visible range, that is 400 to 750 nanometer. If light of shorter wavelength is used within this range, if I am talking about within this range, it means we are talking about the visible spectrum, not shorter than 400. Shorter wavelength within this range means the wavelength from 400 to 500 or 400 to 550, whatever. Okay, the resolution will be higher. This point you should remember, that if light of shorter wavelength is used, within this range, the resolution will be higher. For example, blue light has shorter wavelength than red light. Greater resolution can be obtained using a blue light as a source of illumination than a red light. Now, the second parameter that affects the resolution power of the microscope is the numerical aperture of objective lens. Numerical aperture can be defined as the property of the lens that determines the quantity of light that can enter into it. And this depends on the two factors. The first is refractive index of the medium that fills the space between the specimen and the front of the objective lens. Now, what does this mean? Suppose this is your specimen, okay? And this is your objective lens, right? And this space is filled by oil. So now the medium is not air over here, the medium is lens, and the refractive index depends on the medium that fills the space in between the objective and the front of the objective lens. This is objective. Objective means the specimen that is under study, and this is the objective lens. Okay, now what is refractive index? You must know, this is the ratio of the velocity of light in vacuum as well as in medium. Okay, now the second thing that affects the numerical aperture of the microscope or the numerical aperture of the objective lens is the angular aperture. Okay, now what is angular aperture? The angle between the most divergent rays passing through the lens and the optical axis of the lens. This is known as the angular aperture. I will explain you from the diagram. Just wait. The more divergent or oblique rays that an objective can admit, greater is the resolution power. Okay. Just a minute. I am just erasing this. Suppose this is the optical axis. Okay. This is your objective lens. This is the focus, and this is your object, right? Now this lens is getting so many rays originated from the object. This is first ray, second ray, okay, and one day will be passed through this point, and all these rays which is above and below the optical axis will be passed through the focal length of the objective. So the ray which is more far from the optical axis will be the more divergent rays. What does it mean? Suppose we are using another lens which has aperture more than this lens, then what will happen? This ray will reach over there and be diverted from the focal length of this lens. It means by using the lens of higher aperture we will get the more divergent ray and will get the more angle between the optical between the ray that is passed through the optical axis and that is passed through the other part of the lens. Okay, just a minute, giving you one more example. Just a minute. Okay, this is the optical axis, this is your object, this is your first lens and this is your second lens. Okay, right, this is the ray passed through C and this is the ray passed through the focal length of this smaller lens. Now this is the ray passed through the focal length of larger lens and this is the ray passed through the optical axis of larger lens. Now in this lens we will get the more divergent ray if we compare the divergence of this ray from this ray. Okay, so ultimately we can say that more the angular aperture of the lens we will get the better resolution through the microscope. This can be understood by the equation. Numerical aperture can be mathematically calculated with the help of following formula, that is NA is equal to N sin F, where NA is the numerical aperture, N is the refractive index of the medium and F is the angular aperture. Now let's see how can we calculate the resolution power by using these terms. The resolution power of a bright field microscope can be calculated using the following formula. That is RP or resolution power of the microscope is equal to the wavelength of light used for illumination by 2 multiplied by numerical aperture. For example, if we used yellow light of wavelength 580 nanometer with numerical aperture of 1, then the resolution power of the microscope will be 580 by 2 into 1 is equal to 290 nanometer. This was all about the theory of microscopy. Thanks for your patience. Bye bye.